What's going on, y'all? Welcome back to Steve Busa GS Ring. Got another scorecard reaction for y'all, and you already know what it is. Let's get it. Hey, yo, GS gang, what is good? Take a knee, let's get it popping. Part two, baby, to the tribute. The first one, we let it breathe for a day or two. It's gotten over 1,000 views. You guys have left so many just heartfelt comments. I've seen the hashtags, I've seen all the stories, all the thanks and praise that's going to Mode 9, and honestly, Doug, you guys have filled my heart with this shit. I know we're on the right path. I know we're doing the right thing. When you can bring a community together like that to show that much love to an artist who deserves it, like, we here. We doing it, baby. Let's go. We got five more. We're going to close this out. So we got the last five songs that Mode sent over to me. And there might be one issue. So if you look at the third one, we're going to do Three Kings. This is Rick Ross, Jay-Z, and Mode 9. It's a freestyle. However, the license is with UMG. So just, if you guys don't know this, I'm going to give you a little behind-the-scenes information when it comes to doing reactions. UMG is basically like the devil in terms of copyright strikes, copyright blocks, copyright, like everything, right? Now, I don't get any kind of money for a majority of the videos that we do because of the copyright claims. I don't care about copyright claims. All copyright claim means is that I won't get the revenue for the video that the whoever has the licensing to it, it'll go to them instead. I dispute all of them. Most of them don't go through. It's not really that big of a deal for me. I didn't get into this to get the ad revenue. When I can do that, it's dope, but it's not the reason I do this, so that never slows me down. However, with UMG, the other two things are more serious. So that includes strikes, which will, if I get three in a 90-day period, will actually just terminate my channel and delete all of my videos together. And the other one is a copyright block. So it'll literally, like, I'll sit here and we'll record for an hour, we'll put it up, and the video just won't be viewable by anybody. In which case, it's just complete waste of time. The artist doesn't get anything. We don't get anything. The fans don't get anything. You know what I'm saying? So, like, that's an issue. So I'm just letting you guys know ahead of time. We're going to do it, and I'm going to react to it. I'm probably going to say a lot less during the reaction because I may have to clip that part out. And then once the track is over, I'll give my assessment afterwards. We'll talk about it afterwards. This way, if I have to clip the actual, like, listening to it out of the video, you'll still get my thoughts that'll be included in it afterwards. You on the same page? Cool. All right, let's get into it. Do me a favor. Run the gauntlet. Hit the like button. Hit the subscribe button. Little bell notification guy. We ready to eat. Let's get into it. I did come up with a cool question. So you guys have absolutely killed the hashtag game. Please tweet it out, put it on IG, send it, like, put it wherever you can. Hashtag Mode9Forever. We're to continue with that for this tribute. However, I do have a question. I like the comments where y'all drop the think pieces, where y'all really, like, elaborate and everything like that. I read all of the comments. If you've dropped a comment, I have read it. I may not respond to all of them. It's physically impossible. I try to get to the ones, especially the ones that put more time and take more times into it. So my question for y'all is, I want, in your opinion, what would the Nigerian hip-hop scene look like now without Mode 9? Had his influence not impacted the artist, had not impacted the scene, the culture, and everything like that, how different would it be? And I think that's a really cool way of paying homage. I think being able to read through the comments and really, like, appreciate the impact that we believe from a fan cultural standpoint that it's had, I think that's a really, really dope way of showing love. So let me know if you guys want to feel like writing up, in your opinion, what you think would be different. I would be more than happy to read through all of them and love all of them and shit like that. Let's get into this. But first up, let's get to the bars, baby. Let's go. Mode 9, first one up is Samuel Peter, viral video. Let's go. And I do believe most of these have videos, so we'll full screen it.
That's the winner, como ganador, por knockout técnico. Samuel, the Nigerian Nightmare Peter.
The Nigerian Nightmare is an amazing nickname.
It's dramatic on the
chest. It goes, whoever said Mode 9's gone quiet. Must be on a codeine diet. Shut me out the game, bitch.
That's how you start. Let's go. That's how we started this? Yo, bring it back. Chill. Also, you know what, man? This man's beat selection is so, like, he's very aware. He's very self-aware. He knows the beats that he sounds good on, right? Like, this shit is, come on, man.
It's dramatic.
Yeah, it goes, whoever said mode 9's gone quiet, must be on a codeine diet. Shut me out the game, they tried it, don't deny it. That kind thing, my guy, they cause riots. Pirates do whatever, so they can quick blow. Trying to ask questions, did he ever switch? No, I'm screaming.
Let's go. Let's go.
Go. Not men can give a rat, so get his stone. A mode 9 clone will never possess the Chris flow. You rap with Cisco's, I get a bit pissed though. Approach me at your own risk, oh, you're a bad demon. I better challenge Aristo. See this go? No be disco, check my disco. Graphy, too much sauce, your man chaffy. Last place is not an option, word to the waffies. Test, and I'll be dancing on your grave like Kaffi. Rap Gaddafi, buy your pick without the ending. If I got a problem with you, I don't care who you befriending. Whether you got a million followers.
Let's go! Yo, there's something about the OG-ness combined with the flow that lets him talk like that, dog. Like, there's a certain status you gotta achieve to be able, like, it's a non-aggressive flow with this. He sounds relaxed. He don't sound pressed. It sounds effortless, right? That's the swag that's coming off with it. But it's because of what he's saying and how he's saying it. It's still coming off as super aggressive. Like, he's like, listen to the tone of his voice. He's not straining. He's not really on his rah rah shit. But it's like, it's still kind of given that, you know what I'm saying? Like, let's go, dog.
Bending, the skull will get a dent in. Smash it through a vending machine, reinventing the art of not sending. Leave you hanging like transaction pending. My real fans will be like, mode 9 went in. Man, them on road in London, we'll call this painting. Anderson Silverface, I'm venting. You're fake, everything about you I'm resenting. Your sports car leasing, big house renting. Infiltrate your camp forcefully and pitch my tent in. Harris fencing, your best buddies out the game. Make crank any one of you rappers calling my name. Tap like chicken, about to get slain. The proper 12, quench your thirst for the fame. I be send location and feel the pain. I ain't playing, and don't try to throw this, cause old school English gents will bite joke this. I'm all about my bread like Hovis. The baddest chick in the game sending me roses. When I'm around, her legs never closes. No lie, even Pinocchio knows this.
Is that a bar? Look, I'm not into the TMZ shit. I don't know if that's just a bar. The look on his face when he said it, that sounded believable to me. I'm just putting that. Don't even flood the comments. Don't even flood the comments. It's not TMZ. I don't want the drama. I don't want the gossip. Nothing like that. I'm just telling you from my opinion as a man who has done a lot of shit in his life. That was not the look of a man who came up with the creative bar. That was not the look of a man who was using his creative license as an artist to create some type of illusion. That looked like a reminiscent. That looked like when he said it, when he was like, he could see it in his head. He was like, yeah, now we was in that. We did that, baby.
The prognosis, someone in your staff is a snake word to Moses. This guy Chris, Tobiam is tuberculosis. Verbal flying lotus, only the lanes will flex. My words are so graphic, with the same effects. You hating cause I pass you, and you sprain your necks. Stop acting like you ain't impressed. Stop acting like what gets penetrated in anal sex. I'm a bounce, give me my jacket, the Avil Rex.
Undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, who next?
I want to hear him and Method Man on a track. That ass, like that's what I feel like my hip hop soul would just smile at that. I feel like that would be a good day. That would make my whole day good. I feel like him and Method Man on a track would just do work, right? And only for the 30 and up crowd, dog. Like, it wouldn't even be nothing. I'm not even trying to go, but I just want to hear them talk they shit. On that would, yeah, that would do. That'll do.
I'm ready tomorrow. I'm the best heavyweight champion in the world. I've got the WTC with me.
You know how wild it is to win a heavyweight fight and say I'll be ready to go again tomorrow?
I'm the WTC champion. Undisputed champion. I want who next?
The Nigerian Nightmare. Let's go. All right. So look, I'm going to be honest. That jump right there, that should have been like one of the first ones y'all sent me. Like, yo, like this shit probably would have came out way sooner if this was the tip we was on. Like, let's go. That was fire. That was legitimate fire. All right, Mode 9 and Black Intelligence Spit My Shit Remix. And again, we got the full video. Let's go. Beat selection, dog. Come on, talk about it. The Black Madonna of Africa is fucking fire. Fire.
None of y'all spitter as little as cold as this. I pack an iron fist, go head front like I don't exist. I knock your ancestors back to where your molars is. Moto come doper than stoners just. My style's not free, I charge a fee plus extra bonuses. Rappers are unreliable, I've been alone since. Pharisees are fuming and steaming, I broke the jinx. Shedding the rags of a pauper, wearing robes of a prince. Exterminator, a hologram haters. James Bond villain, feed him to alligators. Now look how mad he made us, thinking he's f***ing faders. I'm still black like the masqueraders. Finger on the trigger of a zap gun, now it's gas and vapors. I'm trying to cop a space shuttle, probably by the Lakers. For astronaut ball and slow-mo dunking on fakers. And you bet, Moto, trying to get the paper. If that don't work out, I rob the bookmaker, neck breaker. I go for the throat, look out. I never battle with my notebook out, but when I spit my, you know I'm dope, no doubt. Ignoring you.
Look, that's such a shot, too. Like, there's definitely, when we start talking about, like, the like pioneers and shit like that, the legends, like, there's definitely a new school and old school mentality. And I can tell you exactly when the shift changed, right? Drake created the shift the second that video came out and he was reading off of his BlackBerry for the freestyle. That was the exact moment that the younger generation was like, cool, I can have my notebook out and go and blow up and make money. That, and I feel like the culture, from the youth standpoint, the culture took a shift at that and no longer valued the idea of penmanship memorization, right? And the other one that I would blame for that too would be Jay-Z. When Jay-Z started telling y'all that he didn't write his raps down and shit like that, a lot of y'all thought that y'all should do that too, and that's what we should pick up. I don't need the notebook. I'm not gonna write this down. And the more y'all fucking said that shit, the more we could tell, because that shit was ass. Now, that being said, I'm the old school head, right? I'm the old school mentality. I think your shit should be memorized. I think you should have that shit practiced and perfected. And if you're gonna go and let some shit come out your mouth, that has your name on it, dog. The second you are gonna step in front of the camera and shit like that, like, you are putting your name on it. So if it's not perfected, if you ain't take the time with your craft to memorize this shit and be able to, like, maintain where you're at, whether you're talking battle rap, whether you're talking ciphers, like, whatever the case may be, like, that's part of your legacy, dog. Like, that, in my opinion, in my old school, old head, washed opinion, that's where I stand, and I don't think that's gonna change. A lot of my views with shit have evolved as we started this channel. I don't think I'm ever gonna get those chips off my shoulder. It's never gonna happen.
You got a problem? Grab a 7D and shoot me. Action, light, you support a bunch of hype. When I X bust the rhyme, disaster strikes.
So get everybody in here. Hey, listen to me. I wrote so many rhymes, you can't memorize all that. And I didn't come here to let y'all down, all right? So this is what I'm gonna do.
This year, one of y'all gonna rap from a wheelchair. It's real.
That was in ref, that audio clip, what was Cannabis, wasn't it? That was the Cannabis versus Disaster battle, I'm pretty sure. I'm gonna bring that back just to make sure. Don't, I'm almost positive that's what that was.
So many rhymes, you can't memorize all that. And I didn't come here to let y'all down, all right? So this is what I'm gonna do.
This year, one of your.
That was a heartbreaking moment in hip hop for me. That was a hard day. That was a hard day at work. That was a hard day at work watching that happen, dog.
Gonna rap from a wheelchair, it's real hair. Rap careers will get killed here, feel fair. I'm anti-humanitarian. You in the building, motors in the planetarium. Barbaric, a barbarium. First bar, raise them. Last bar, bury them. Vegetarian, beef eater, one of the nicest. Watch me, March 4th, and no one.
Stop, bring that back. Hold up. We not gonna get through this one. Hold up.
Rares will get.
This whole, oh my god.
All right, so
Look, do you know how disrespectful it is to come off of cannabis choking? To come off of an audio clip of cannabis choking and deliver that flow like that, dog?
What am I doing?
This year, one of y'all gonna rap from a wheelchair. It's real hair. Rap careers will get killed here. Feel fair. I'm anti-humanitarian. You in the building, motors in the planetarium. Bar for bar, I'm barbaric, a barbarium. First bar, raise them. Last bar, bury them. Vegetarian, beef eater, one of the nicest. Watch me, March 4th, and no, I'm not Pisces. I'm Gemini, half android with no vices. Now look, cause nothing ever stopped us from...
There he goes again with the no vices. I fuck with this man, I really do, dog. Let's go!
Just interrupt us. If you understood that, nerd, congratulations. If you didn't, it's withdrawal before ejaculation. No prophylactic, no procreation. I'm fresh with the raw, that's a crazy combination. Original monarch, no coronation. This is real rap, man, world domination.
The original monarch, no coronation. That was hard, that was hard. I'm not gonna lie, this second part of this tribute is my shit. The second part is This feels different. This feels like, I don't know if it's the song selection, I don't know if it's coming off of the high energy of the first one or what. This feels different. This was different, dog. Yo, that was fire. I'm in. Alright, what's this? Alright, so we got this joint now. Let's get through this. Look, best case scenario, we get through it, no problems. Worst case scenario, it's one track that we have to cut out of the whole tribute. You know what I'm saying? So let's get it.
Visit irockin.com for more Nigerian music anytime, anywhere.
You're welcome for the free promo.
See y'all niggas. Hit the switches on that shit one time. Huh. Let the top down. I came a long way from the weed game. 20 stack seats at the heat game. And I'm still strapped with the heat, man. Can't be stepping on the nigga feet, man. Hey, pass niggas came from the D game. Cause it was a grip. Said it was a C thing. Brown bag money in a duffel bag. Fuck them all with them, then we got a double bet. The homie whipping chickens in his mama kitchen. On a mission, say he did it for his son tuition. Real niggas' dreams coming to fruition. Stumble, but I never fall, leaning on my pistol. I only love her when the ass fat. We should listen to this track in my Maybach. I'm just trying to be a billionaire. Come and suck a dick for a millionaire.
It's just different. I know it feels different. I only love it for eyes brown. Play this shit while you play around with my crown. King H.O., y'all should know by now. But if you don't know, meanness on the wall in all my rooms. Niggas couldn't fuck with my daughter's room. Niggas couldn't walk in my daughter's socks. Banksy bitches, Basquiat. I ran through that buck 50 Live Nation running me. They working on another deal, they talking 250. I'm holding out for three. 275 and I just might agree.
Look, I don't even really fuck with luxury rap like that. Like, it's never been my twist. I enjoy it occasionally, right? Especially, like, some tracks are just undeniable. Whether it's your twist or not, some shit is just undeniable, right? But, like, I'm very curious how Mode's gonna fit on this right now. I'm not, like, even... He's even said in the freestyles that we've listened to on this tribute that, like, he's not into all that. Like, that's not his twist, you know what I'm saying?
Steve Boy used to park my Beamer. Now look at me, I can park in my own arena. I only love it for weaving, no, I'm still a hood nigga. What you want me to do? And hopping out the BM with your BM. Taking the places you can't go with your BDM. Screaming copy DM until I'm a dead poet. Robin Williams shit, I deserve a Golden Globe, bitch.
I take an ace in the meanwhile. You ain't gotta keep this calendar, just a freestyle. Fuck rap money, I made more of crates. Fuck show money, I spent that on traits. Close the curtain, fuck boy out my face. I whip the coat, let the lawyer beat the case.
I've had the same curtains for fucking 15 years. Like, I can't relate, dog. It's not...
Murder was the case that they gave me. I killed the Hermes store, somebody save me. Stuntin' to the max like baby. Oh, shit. Oh, stuntin' to the max, I'm so wavy. Used to shop with TJ Maxx back in 83. I don't even know if it was open then. I ain't no Oprah then. Had the XL80 bike. Loud motor, they be like, damn, when I'm coming through, rain. Some of my fans lost me, now they club heads. They pay too much attention to what the blog said. Neanderthal mode swinging, I club heads. No Flintstone, Captain K-Man, you drop dead. I body the beat, for hip-hop heads. They try to shut me down, cause I did not beg. Founded the movement, I gave hip-hop legs. To run things, kick hard raps from bottom up. They criticize cause my song's not dumb enough. The dome is what I'm coming off. Never wear tight jeans. Cut through the dark like spotlight beams. Black.
I really want to wait till afterwards to say this, cause if I gotta cut it out, I'm gonna be so mad. When I tell you Mo9 is speaking for an entire generation, dog. Like, there are clear generational separations in hip-hop. And there's nothing wrong with it. I would never be the one to slight anybody who came up on the skinny jean wave or even the mumble rap wave. All the way, here's how I look at it. And this, I'm going to be 100% real with you, right? If there is an opportunity for a kid or a man or a woman or whatever the case may be to use the music to better their life and get out of their situation, it doesn't matter whether or not I like the music. I still support them. I still want to see every mumble, even though it's not my taste and it's not the shit I listen to, I want to see all of them be successful. I would never want $1 to be taken out of nobody's pocket because of my taste in music. I think one of the most beautiful things about music is it gives kids the opportunity to change their stars. Like, it don't matter where you're from, it don't matter like what your background is, don't matter what your education level is and shit like that. Like, hip-hop specifically really took a talented generation or a group of generations that were talented and had this skill set and gave them an avenue, gave them an outlet to better their fucking lives. Now, that being said, I want to make that clear, he's talking to us, dog. Like, there's no weight I would ever, like, no amount of fitness I would ever get into where I would wear skinny jeans. Like I said, it's just, it's not in my blood. It's not in my DNA. It's not the cloth that I'm cut from. So, like, when you hear certain artists that speak from a certain point of view and shit like that, I'm very curious to see who are the ones that he's talking to. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you as a fan, does that, like, offend you because you're part of the newer generation? Or is that, like, are you like me? You old and washed and shit like that. And we just like, yo, like, this, he's talking to me. Like, that's, like, that's for me, dog. Let's go.
Never wear tight jeans. Cut through the dark like spotlight beams. Black Moor slash Othello slash Black African. Polymath drop jewels, I'm never flashing them. Rounding garbage rap.
Ooh, he recycled that. Is that like a tagline? Because we've heard that on one of his more recent ones, right? That was on the first, he dropped that bar on the first jump.
Flashing them, H2S or force flashing them, left, right, center. Baby rappers puff and get buried with their placenta. I keep it 100, you a 5% not the Clarence 30 next type, you misrepresent a tenor who buy you out your contract. Young cats wanna top.
Oh shit, I think I figured it out. I don't think he dropped that in the previous joint. I think the previous joint sampled this. Like, I think this one is 2012. This is dated before the other one, and the other one, the beat was chopped and mixed, and part of the scratches included that line. I think that's what it was. That's fire. That's fire. Right? See, like, this is the journey. This is part of the journey. But, like, the one side of the tribute is, like just straight up showing respect and showing love and giving the fans the opportunity to have their legend on a platform and, like give flowers, right? That's, like, the one side of it. The other side of it is y'all have to realize I've never heard this before. I'm still on my musical journey. I'm still educating myself song after song. I'm still getting to sink my teeth into new music every single time that we press play. So while half of my mind is like, man, we're here to show love. We're here to, you know what I'm saying, to give flowers. The other half of my mind is in like geeked out fan mode. Like I'm still picking up and discovering shit for myself and stuff like that. Plus not to mention what y'all put me onto in the comments. So like that was that. I think I'm pretty sure I'm spot on with that one. Feel free to correct me in the comments.
Been high jumping. I raised the bar dumplings. You need to be pole vaulting. I'm provoking. Payback's overdue. Soon I'll be stutting like Rick Ross and Hoverdude. Three kings, one crown, mortal murder the other two. Ghostface killer minus throwing up the W. The truth trouble you. I know you hate my guts. Your chick's a sket, but you haven't even touched a buck. She's at my every beck and call whenever I want to bust her nut. You're like a hole in a hexagon. You're just a nut. I'm King Tuck. Get it off your chest. Mode is the best. I'm making good music in the studio, no rest. Debunch, get on the phone and call Kanye West. Tell him to call Jay and Rose. Make it disturb them. That cat, Mode 9, damn, is a problem. I kill rappers on tracks and wake them up and flog them. They shook two fingers at their back, we'll probably rob them. Now let's talk about these fans. Nah, fuck them. I say fuck them, mother, fuck damn. Them. Mode 9 is number one, yeah, fuck not them. Them. And this is just another freestyle. I didn't write it down. These cats are clowns, always talking shit. They say I'm remixing.
I still hate that. I don't care who says it. I hate the concept of not writing the rhymes down.
Their face need fixing. The shit they say is all fixing. All made up, like a clown's face. Three kings.
A little bit of an abrupt end right there. Stab it. Alright, so let's take a second here. In case that gets cut out and we have the clip right here, like, this is where we come back in at, right? Like, yo, that was fire. First of all, Mode 9 ate them. I don't think there anyone would debate that. We got two verses that were basically just surface level luxury rap. You know what I'm saying? Which I gave it right before. It is what it is. It's not for me, but you know, some shit will still make you scrunch your face up. I can't relate to it. You know, I'm still poor, but it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? Mo came in, he shut that shit down. That was fire. That was absolutely fire. I do believe we probably should have listened to this one first on the list. I think that part of this was cut and clipped on one of the previous freestyles with the Mode 9, don't fucking flash jewels or flash gems, I just drop them. I think that part was sampled on one of the previous freestyles we heard. That legacy moment is big, dog. Being there, like paying enough attention to be able to pick up on shit like that, that's what we're here for, dog. That's what separates us from the other channels. You know what I'm saying? Like, I fuck with that. Let's go. We got two more. We got Pay Attention. Let's get it. Let me know what your thoughts are on all this. Yo. You notice the little play on words they got, like, they spoon-fed you right there. Pay attention.
Pay attention.
You wish you was in the position I'm in. You wish you was in the position I'm in. Every time I touch my ear off freak screen. You wish you was in the position I'm in. I'm on the street scene. You wish you was in the position I'm in. Every time I touch my ear off freak screen. You wish you was in the position I'm in. I'm on the street scene.
I love Biggie, but I don't rock Gucci, man. I burn your wax seat, now you walk a flock of flame. Talk tough on Twitter, I block a lane. I am Vasily Zaitsev with the aim. Making it rain, but see your brain, pellets of pain. You rock funny gold, Chris Tucker chain. Forget the Chris over Ops, Tucker chain. I let him know lyric-wise, you're taking a piss in the wind. Well, I'll be taking your miss to the end. Tipsy up the tonic and gin. Cyber love making, terabyte RAM and a stallion stamina. My memory sticking them out. Download, remove the Trojan and I'm kicking it out. I'm not always like this, psych's what I'm about. And I promise this year I will not swear. Two fingers crossed behind my back, fuck out of here.
You wish you was in the position I'm in.
It's interesting to see his flow switches and stuff like that. This is probably my least favorite one that he's done. But you gotta appreciate the versatility. You know what I'm saying? Like, you would get so sick of somebody if they sounded the same on every single track. You gotta be able to go in there and flex your different styles and shit like that. So I appreciate it, man.
You wish you was in the position I'm in. I'm on the street scene. You wish you was in the position I'm in. Every time I touch my ear off the freak screen. You wish you was in the position. say I'm ballin', but we in a different league, y'all. I'm above D-Law, break bones like Seagull. If it's beef, we can back and forth and fuck a seesaw. I'm guaranteed to eat y'all, even if you be raw. Repertoire.
He's back!
My Tommy Hearns, without the weak jaw. Your girl's a cheap whore, she freaked me for free, y'all. Hit it till her butt cheeks sore, fuck a freestyle. I spit a pricey verse that you pay a fee for. Don't cross me, cause...
Fuck a freestyle, I'll spit a pricey verse that you pay a fee for. Let's go, alright, I'm back in.
Tall. I raise the roof, you suicidal, so you leap off. My rhyme pass barbed wire, danger keep off. Else you get it zapped when my laser gun bleeps off. Chicken heads wanna talk, I smack a beak off. I got a new one, I'm proud, suck my peacock. A deep throat, my street talk, and tell your weak boss that if I catch him, he should get ready for teeth loss.
That was one of those parts we'd have brought back 100 times at the house parties, dog. Let's go. Also, I like the whole, like, yo, I'm gonna try something new on the first verse. Give you a second to talk your shit, and then I'ma shut you the fuck down and let you remember who you talking to in a second. You right, my guy. You right.
I send the position I'm in every time I touch my feel off the quick screen. You wish you was in the position I'm in.
This beat is crazy.
I'm on the street scene. You wish you was in the position I'm in every time I touch my feel off the quick screen. You wish you was in the position I'm in. I'm on the street scene. You wish you was in the position I'm in every time I touch my head off the freak screen. You wish you was in the position I'm in. I'm on the street scene. You wish you was in the position I'm in every time I touch my head off the freak screen. You wish you was in.
Are we just looping this for 60 seconds plus?
I'm on the street scene.
I'm not mad about this is because the beat is fired. I've had to outwardly say that like 3 times on the same reaction, so I'm with it. This gives me house party vibes. This is the shit when I was a young bull, we was throwing the house parties and shit like that. This is the type of shit we was doing. Now obviously it wasn't Mode 9, it was fucking G-Unit and Fabulous and shit like that, you know what I'm saying? But like this give me that like getting a fucking Wally from Shorty while Victory freestyles on type shit, you know what I'm saying?
Alias, I'm Mode 9, baby.
I'm assuming Alias is the one who produced that, made the beat. That shit was fire. Huge shout out to Alias. Alright, last one. We about to close the tribute off, man. What has been your favorite part so far? If you haven't commented, if you've watched this and you haven't dropped a comment, you haven't gone onto a social media, drop the hashtag to show some love for Mode 9, this is your reminder. This is your opportunity. Don't let these tributes go to waste. The whole point of the platform isn't for you to tell me, hey, I'm glad that you did this. I don't need the praise. All praise is due to the artist. I am just an observer of the culture. I'm just a fan who is appreciative of the music, who is very selfishly being able to come in and pluck music and add it to my playlist. Please, please, please take this opportunity to drop a comment somewhere, drop a hashtag somewhere. Show this man some love. You feel me? We're going to close this off. We got Nigel Benz Kraftwerk, the Soul Edition, fresh. Let's get it. This is how we going to end the tribute, baby.
Benz Kraftwerk. No bless in the building. Nobody.
Ain't nobody fresher than me. Ain't nobody fresher than me. Ain't nobody fresher than me.
Are we getting like real old school vibes now? Let's go.
Y'all ain't fresher than me. Ain't nobody fresher than me. Ain't nobody fresher than me. Ain't nobody fresher than me. It's plain to see. Y'all ain't fresher than me. Freestylers get touchy cause my rhythm leave us dead. I put a sword to your neck so you can rhyme off the head. I kick a verse but I'd rather kick you for claiming that you're married to the game when it don't dig you. That's why you're breaking up like four phone signals on big news.
Hold up, that's kinda hard, dog. That's kind of hard. We've heard, look, traditionally I've heard a million married to the game bars, right? I've heard a million other bars of rappers dissing cats who claim they're married to the game. That was probably one of my favorite flips I've heard on it.
me with beef. Money is the root of evil. Here, smoke the leaf. You wouldn't get the picture. Like a whack art thief, me and the beat go together better than blade and sheath. I'm chief wordsmith, ahead of my class. Word blatant now, watch me. Score with a pass, God is great to infinity. Do the Sunday mass, receive your miracle. I put a healing to your ass. Hate on my skills, I no sense. I'll just go back in time and kill your father's best friend. So you won't be born, bastard. The end.
Fresh.
Ain't nobody fresher than me. Ain't nobody fresher than me. Oh, one, two.
That might be the most roundabout way to off somebody's mama I ever heard in my life.
Oh, one, two. Ain't nobody.
Why would we ended on a real violent note on this tribute? We here for it, baby. Let's go.
Me, it's plain to see. Y'all ain't fresher than me.
Oh, one, two. Oh, one, two.
Ain't nobody fresher than me. Ain't nobody fresher than me. Ain't nobody fresher than me. It's plain to see. Y'all ain't fresher than me. I roll with a nice crew, so I'm one of the kind. Dr. Einstein, I derail your one-track mind. With a hotline, punchline, smoking off the hook. I made you look, look, I got Medusa's head in my hand. Y'all don't need to be junkies to get stoned, my man. Damn, you told hot lead, your pencil must be burning.
Look, this is like, this is what, like, when I was coming up, like, very old school Cypher sounded like this. These are like Cypher verses and shit like that. That Medusa line, at the time when that type of hip-hop was king, would have sent people crazy. Like, you gotta appreciate, like, the time and place of writing and shit like that. If you know, you know. If you was outside when that type of shit was popping, that was one of those ones where everyone's face would have scrunched up and they'd looked at the person next to him and shit like that. That was one of those moments, though.
A werewolf, 12 o'clock, I'm turning, wiping out your vermins, hindering your advancement. Get some silicon, cause what you bust needs enhancement. Little kids coming at me like it's beef. I kick them in the mouth so they can all taste defeat. You die in your sleep if you doze on the skill. I got the thought of being the best for a shot, but you ponder it. I raise the bar for lyrics. Y'all can do the limbo under it and blunder it, cause your whole style is confetti. When I see the fake, I chop knuckle with a machete.
Fresh.
Ain't nobody fresher than me. Ain't nobody fresher than me. Oh, one, two. Oh, one, two. Ain't nobody fresher than me. It's plain to see. Y'all ain't fresher than me.
Oh, one, two.
Ain't nobody fresher than me. Ain't nobody fresher than me.
This is actually gonna be stuck in my head. This is actually gonna be stuck in my head all night.
Yeah. Ain't nobody fresher than me. It's plain to see. Y'all ain't fresher than me.
Modo. Wah. Nine Stein. Kraftwerk. Niger Ben. You fresh, man. You fresh like vegetables,
you know what?
Man. You fresh.
Actually, you know what? The Genius made a comment on one of my Twitter posts saying to call him Modo and not to say Mode. And I just recognize that right now with him saying that. Is that a thing? If at any point in time, me saying Mode short for Mode 9 instead of Modo, I shouldn't have to say this, but I will. It's definitely not a sign of respect. If anything, it's just a sign of ignorance. You know what I'm saying? So if that's like a thing, just let me know. I will do my best to correct that going forward. It was in the back of my head, I just remembered. I randomly seen a tweet about that. And I don't know if that's like... Sometimes, you know, it's hard to differentiate between, like, gang just, like, playing with you and shit like that versus something that's, like, nah. Like, they're trying to give you, like, a heads up. Like, don't do that.
Fresh like morning dew. They can't touch you. Wow.
Was that it? We done? That's it, baby. We done. All right, yo. How y'all feel about that? Let's go. Yo, Mo9, if you guys check this out, I love you. I appreciate you. This has all been for you. I hope you check the comments. I hope you check the hashtags. I hope you genuinely feel the love from all the people that you have influenced, from the impact that you've had on a culture that all of us have had the luxury of being able to observe and participate in any capacity that the GS gang has been able to. This has just been one big-ass session to give flowers. The second half of this was fire, dog. Like, I'm 100% in on this. I look forward to getting a chance to chop it up. We do have, hopefully, a Mode 9 interview coming shortly. After this, I'm going to hit him up. We're going to try and set up a date for what works for him. If you guys have any type of questions, topics, anything like that you would like to hear us chop up and talk about, especially if it's about any of the music that you've heard, clarification on anything, let me know what you guys feel about it. We'll do our best to give you guys the best interview possible. As always, I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. I will catch y'all on the next one. Let's go. That was fire. I'm bringing that other freestyle back.